Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube, and in this video, I'm gonna do a quick introduction to R in Power BI. Stay tuned. If you're finding this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right, I did a video on introducing you guys to Python in Power BI, so I decided to do one introducing you to R in Power BI. So you guys know what I like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. The first thing you gotta do, just like Python, you go to File, Options and Settings, and Options. And I'll be honest, this was much, much simpler than doing the Python scripting. You have your two choices, R scripting, Python scripting, choose R. And you can see I've already installed it. There's lots of different flavors. If you're not sure which one or what to go and do, just click on how to install R. It'll take you to this link right here, and then it'll walk you through what you need to do. If you just click on this download page or whichever version of R you want to install, it'll open up this link, and then you can go and choose which one you want based on the machine. Obviously, if you're running Power BI desktop, it's going to be Windows. So once you do that, then you'll have option here to choose which version of R you want to run. So you can see I'm using the R server, but it doesn't matter. And then choose the IDE. I'm just using the default one for my operating system. So we're going to click OK. Once you do that, just like with Python, you can import and prep and massage and get intimate with your data with R, and you can visualize your data with R. I'm going to show you both. So first we're going to get some data. So we choose get data, more, and then the little dialog window will pop up. And if you type R scripting, you'll see there it goes, R script. And you click on R script and you click connect. And then right here, it's really simple. You type data and there's a list. I just did a search out on the interwebs, and I found a page that had so many R data sets. And you go find one. I like this MT Cars right here, Motor Trend Car Road Test. So I just picked that one. So you go here, you type data, MT Cars, and you can do other things here also, but this is the simplest and the purest form of it. Click OK. It's gonna do its thing behind the scenes, open up the Navigator window, and then you can see my MT Cars data set. So we'll do just like that, and then you can see all my data. I'm gonna go ahead and click Transform just so you can see that if I want to, I can go and do some transformations of the data. And you can see right here, AM means transmission type. I believe 0 is automatic and 1 is manual, but doesn't matter, right? I've connected to this data with R. If you right click on the query itself and go to advanced editor, you can see that the M is pretty simple. If I go to add column with that AM column selected, and I do column from selection, I can go if AM is 1, this will be manual. And if AM is 0, it's automatic. That's column from example for me, transmission type. And then if I click OK, I can import my data. I can do the transformations in R, or I can do it in Power Query. Completely up to you. I'm gonna go ahead and click close and apply. I've just imported my data with R. Then I did some transformations with M or Power Query. And now I'm gonna visualize my data with R. It's pretty cool. It's pretty simple. So now you click in the white space on your report. You'll see over in the visualization pane, you have the Python visual and the R visual. Go ahead and click the R visual. Get the same prompt. Let's go ahead and enable it. And now we need to drag the fields that we want to use in our R script into the value section for that element. So I'm going to go ahead and expand this out, and I'm going to drag over miles per gallon and the number of cylinders. What you need to make sure is that the columns that you're going to use, you set the default summarization to none. So the very first one, it should be, now it's set to sum. So we're going to say do not summarize. And then for cylinder, we're going to set it to do not summarize. And then we can start writing our script. So what I want to do, I don't want to create a visual that's already there. So what I'm going to do is create a box plot. And so this code is automatically generated for us. It automatically creates this data frame to remove duplicates when it's executed. So I'm actually going to use this. And so what we're going to do is type box plot, and then I'm going to say data set $, and I'm going to use miles per gallon. Look at the IntelliSense. And then I'm going to say data set $. When I run this, we should get our box and whisker plot just like that. Just really small sample of R scripting in Power BI. What's nice about it though, like with the Python visual, everything interacts. Remember that transmission type column that I created? If I drop that onto the design surface and use my slicer and click it, you'll see how things change just a little bit based on that. The interaction between the two vision is fully built in. Now you can take this to the next level, and I already wrote a script. If you want to add titles to your axis and to your report and things like that, if I go to the formatter, I can turn off the title, and then I'll just do like a cooking show, paste this in and go ahead and run this script, and then boom, you'll see how nice and fancy it is. It's got colors and different things like that. Just based on my R script. It's pretty easy. Didn't do a whole bunch of work, but you know, there it is. You can add so many properties to this box plot. Now, before I go, there are some limitations. You need to make sure you go and read the full documentation here. Go to the known limitation sections and be aware of that. Learn about the requirements and limitations of the R packages that are available in the service. The last thing, just like Python, you need to have the personal gateway if you want to refresh these data sets once you publish them out to Power BI. All right, what do you guys think? You have any questions, comments? Are you using R? I'd love to know. Let's continue the conversation where? In the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video. R.